How to turn plastic pellets to 3D filament with high quality. We will show you how to obtain it, explaining the correct plastic consistency, every extruder parameter to take account, and even how to obtain the post-production filament data, helping you to obtain great filament. Today we will prepare red PLA filament. So the first thing you need to do is mix in the PLA pellets and red pigment master batch at 3% proportion. Then just throw them inside the extruder hopper. Now it's time to make some measurements. We will only need two for this test. The first one is the spool width. This one measures 69 mm. The second one is the inner diameter. For this one is 106 mm. Write down these parameters as we will need them later. Then just unscrew the winder and make sure the spool stays parallel to the filament guide, obtaining better filament winding. Now it's time to turn on the machine, but before we do it, don't forget to introduce the SD card to obtain the filament data. Let me show you how to reset previous profile data. It is very easy. First, select the Reset Profile option. Once selected, just select the saved profile you want to erase, and that's it. Now we can select it to use it for this experiment. Before any extrusion, the machine makes the homing of the filament guide. This makes sure that the machine starts in the same place every time we turn off the machine. There are several initial parameters to configure. The first two are the temperature set point for both heaters, being the number two the one at the end of the extruder. For this experiment, I will introduce lower extrusion temperatures to show you what happens. Next, I need to introduce the spool dimensions I have measured previously. The other outer parameters for both dimensions are used only when special dimensions spools are used. Otherwise, they are not necessary to modify. Now let's select the initial position for the filament guide. You need to move it to the start of the spool. You can use a ruler or something similar to make sure it is on the correct position. You can modify the filament diameter set point. You can modify it afterwards, but we recommend changing it only in this screen. Otherwise, you might not get correct information at the parameter information screen. The last parameter is in charge of the total number of meters to make. Don't worry, it's only to set the acoustic alarm. You will be able to surpass this number as much as you want. Okay, everything is ready. If the screen changes to orange, it means that the extruder is heating up. Just wait until the extruder heaters have arrived to the set point. The screen will change to green, and the alarm will make an intermittent sound. It will stop when you move the knob. As we already had material inside the extruder and we have selected low temperature set points, the material hasn't melted yet and the extruder motor has stopped. But don't worry, this will happen to you many times at the beginning until you get the correct temperature. You might have to wait when using the brass nozzle to make sure the plastic at the end is melted properly. Once the extruder motor is activated, make sure to protect the surface below the nozzle. Use cardboard or similar. Also remove the filament holders to make it easier for you when moving the filament afterwards. Now the filament is coming up, but you cannot use it straight away. You need to wait until it comes out regularly and consistently. Otherwise, you won't obtain good filament. The plastic is ready to become filament. So go to the windscreen and turn on the width measure block. We recommend to use first the tune option, allowing us to select constant speed for the initial filament. Each mode will allow us to configure one different parameter. On auto, it is possible to change the diameter set point, and on tune, to modify the width block manual speed. Time to move the filament. Take a pair of tweezers and a wire cutter, then grab the melted plastic and drive it through the fans, the pulley and the oscillation reducers until you arrive to the width block. Make sure to select low speeds for the extruder motor to make easier this process. Once the filament is being pulled by the width block, modify its speed to obtain a proper filament tension. Okay, now that the filament is in place and being pulled properly, it is time to increase the filament production. To do so, just return to the start screen and increase the motor RPM. As you can see, the width block has increased its speed, keeping up with the new plastic output. Changing from the previous 18mm per second to 28. Even though, let's increase it a bit more to 35 to move closer to the 1.75mm diameter set point. While the filament diameter is setting down, let's tweak the oscillation reducers properly to reduce any tension due to vibration. Once the filament is close to the set point, just change the width mode to auto, and the extruder will take care of the rest. Once the filament is close to the set point, it's time to wind it. To do so, go to the off parameter and select the auto mode. Two new values will appear. One is the offset value, used to manually make the winder spin faster or slower, and the second is the set point for the tension sensor. For now, just leave selected the tension sensor parameter. We will need it soon. Time to introduce the filament into the spool. Normally you can use the inner holes from the spool, but sometimes you may need duct tape to attach the filament. First cut the filament and introduce it through the sensor filament as we do, and attach it to the spool. Once you make sure it is correctly secured, go to the LCD and change the value of the tension sensor parameter to the value DIS, which means disabled. This will start the spooling session. Make sure that the first filament laps are tied up to avoid any future problems. Now, to reduce the leftover filament, we return to the winder offset value and select a positive value to increase the speed of the winder to eliminate the extra filament. Please be careful with this and have ready the value 0, or else the filament might break or worse. Once you get rid of the leftover, return to the tension sensor set point parameter and choose a value similar to the one is measuring the sensor. We have selected 12, as the sensor is measuring values around 12. This value will fine-tune the filament tension in real time during the spooling session. Right now, everything is set up, so you only need to wait to obtain your own custom filament. Let's have a look at how it's doing right now. You already know the basics, so let's look at other features this machine has and several recommendations as well. For instance, it has an info screen where you can see all sensor and parameter values from the other screens as well as new values, such as the total meters made and the process time. This time also includes heating and other standby actions, not only the spooling time. Let's look at the filament we made so far. Imagine that you don't like the filament or you have completely filled your spool. Instead of stopping the process and begin again, You can just wind a new spool without stopping anything if you have another one with the same dimensions. Let me show you. First thing you need to do is stop the winder. It will stop turning and you will be able to reduce the filament you have produced. Once extracted, you can introduce another spool. Then just select the reset option to reset every parameter and position. You can see how the filament guide is moving to the initial position. Then you just need to take the same steps we did earlier in this video. Let me show you at fast speed. Okay, let's see how it's going, our second filament spool. It has better look than the first we made, so let's stop the process and evaluate the results. Remember to update the profile if you like the selected parameters. Take the SD card and go to your computer. Once you open the SD card, at least two types of documents will appear, info and data. There may be as many data files as spools made. This is why there are two data documents. The info file has a summary of the initial parameters selected and the specific parameters for each spool, even the total meters made and the time. The data files have only the temperature for each heater and the filament measuring during the extrusion time. Data is ready to be represented in any spreadsheet. To make things easier, we have made a small program just to visualize these parameters. Let's look at the first spool data. You just need to select the file and in which axis you want to represent the data. As you can see, this spool should be close to 1.75 mm. But the initial values were far from set point. Let's look at the second spool data to compare both of them. As you can see, these results are far more better than the first spool, so we have a winner. We have shown you how to make your own filament and several perks that this machine has. There are several extra things you should know, but we will leave them for next videos. Thank you for your time. Stay tuned for more information.